Well, I'm actually upstairs in the master bedroom recording this. My husband is on the phone downstairs because today is his birthday. And I'm not sure when I will be able to post this, but I wanted to at least begin it. And hopefully within the next week and a half or so, I'll be able to get it edited and to share with you because it's an exciting video for me. First of all, I hope you had a wonderful holiday season. If you follow me at all on Instagram or my Marcia's Cottage by the Sea page, I shared a little bit about our holiday, and unfortunately, my husband and I both came down with the virus. He actually got it first, and then I got it, and together it just took us through the holidays. And believe it or not, I actually learned something from it, that I'm going to cut back next year on my holiday activities, because having to get that rest, taking a break, relaxing, being at home, enjoying this time of year was such a wonderful blessing for me. Honestly, I just couldn't believe, you know, how healing and soulful the time was for me. And of course, I'm just speaking for myself because it's no fun to get that sick. But after the original sickness is kind of behind me and I just needed to rest, I appreciated so much almost having an excuse because I was sick and not feeling my topmost best to stay at home and just relax. So we said no to some things that we usually do, and we decided to just take care of ourselves during this time. And I just found it, again, such a wonderful blessing for this time of year. It's it reminds me of the winter solstice when things seem so dark, and so the light comes again. However, for me, the light came during that period of time when I just kind of got refreshed and started feeling better. And I read, I didn't do all the activities I usually do. And at first I was a little bit disappointed. And then as time went on, I actually was surprised how much I enjoyed it. Our usual Nutcracker ballet experience was canceled. We had tickets out of town to go see it. We had a whole week within a week time frame planned for shopping and just so many things. But because we both got ill, we had to take care of ourselves in a different way. So anyway, I hope you're doing well. And what I'm going to be sharing with you is a meal that I actually prepared for New Year's Eve and also for my husband's birthday, because he celebrates his birthday today. And I wanted to make it special in so many ways. Well, first of all, because he's wonderful. He's a wonderful man. And his birthday, like, I enjoy having my birthday around the holidays, but I don't know if I would enjoy having it on New Year's Eve, because, you know, as I get older, I don't really want to be around a large party and things like that. So anyway, I wanted to make it really special for him. And so what I did is I made tamales, and I'm so excited to share it with you. I tried to record the whole process. And just a little background, I actually grew up in a family that made tamales every holiday season. We had it for Christmas, and then they carried on into the New Year's. Before I was born, it was a tradition in my family. And as I have memories of it, my father and my grandmother would sit at a table and they would have everything spread out. And it was, when I look back on it, it was like a special social time particularly for them. And as I have memories of getting a little bit older, maybe in junior high, high school, I would come home from being out and or on a date, and there they would be at the table making tamales, and they'd say, would you like to sit down and put the masa on the corn husk or put some cheese or chilies? And I would help a little bit, but I've never made them from scratch. So this is a big deal for me into my sixth decade of life to actually create tamales on my own. And the other thing was, I mentioned it to one of my nieces, and I asked her if she had a good recipe. I had found one because I'm a vegetarian, and I didn't want to necessarily put pork or chicken or anything in it. So pretty much just cheese and green chilies. And she said she had found a recipe, and I compared it to the one I had found. And hers was actually a little bit easier, so that's the recipe I tried first. And what I already have plans for my next experience with making tamales and what I'm gonna do and what I'm not gonna do. However, I'm so proud of these, and I believe this might just be a tradition that I get to begin in my sixth decade of life. Because it was so enjoyable for me. I just had memories of my father, my grandmother while I was, you know, making it. I enjoyed going out and getting the ingredients and deciding what to do. My husband got when he purchased a pot. Unfortunately, this was happening right when we were getting better and we could get out for small periods of time. So I think that's about it. I hope I haven't spoken too much before I start sharing, because I'll have to edit all of this. And what I wanted to do is I actually brought one up into the bedroom just to show you close up. Excuse me, I still have kind of a congested thing going on. So this is my tamale, and I went ahead and did the little ties. I actually have some cooking right now because that's what I'm serving him for his birthday dinner. And I made a Boston cream pie too. And what I am so proud of, because I can remember as a little girl, my grandmother and my father were very particular how you spread the masa on. And so as I was preparing these and making them, I was having memories of those conversations. And it's just a very soulful time for me. I'm sorry that the camera is shaking a little bit. I made the decision to just hold it today. So anyway, I hope you are doing well. I hope you like this video. And again, I'm gonna try to get it up not too late in the beginning of the month. I am running behind on so many things. And anyway, take care, and I hope you enjoy this video.
Tradition, tradition, tradition. night must grab it for a living, feed a wife and children, say his daily prayers, and who has the right, there's master of the house, who have the final word at home. The papa, the papa, tradition, the papa.
She's pretty.
The sons, the sons. Tradition, the sons, the sons. Tradition.
And who does Mama teach to mend and tend and fix? Preparing me to marry whoever Papa picks.
The daughter.
You gave me 2 kopecks.
I had a bad week.
So, if you had a bad week, why should I suffer?
Rabbi, may I ask you a question?
Certainly, my son.
Is there a proper blessing for the Tsar?
A blessing for the Tsar? Of course.
May God bless and keep the Tsar.
Far away from us.
La da da da, la da da da.